Much like.
All right. Hey, everybody.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi. Christmas troll.
Indeed. Welcome to this week's Last Week in Gaming. And we are filming at She Geeks, your one-stop shop for everything board and card games, as always.
So what's on the docket today?
World of Warcraft.
Oh, my favorite topic.
Free World of Warcraft.
Free? Even more favorite.
A free server.
Ah, but what kind of server is it, though?
It's a vanilla server. It's actually, it was one of the biggest or the biggest vanilla WoW free server.
Nostalros.
Yes. And it got shut down a couple of... There goes the other ball. It got shut down a couple of months ago by Blizzard.
Okay.
But they've been talking with Blizzard, and it's coming back.
Oh, okay.
With all the accounts intact, as far as I've heard. So if you were kicked out at level, what, you could be 16
vanilla? 16 for vanilla, yeah.
Then you'll still have all of your characters. And
that's good.
Whatnot.
Good guy, Blizzard.
As far as I know, they're bringing the server back because Blizzard has not pronounced themselves on the subject of bringing vanilla servers on their own.
They have. They said, oh, we're really interested about bringing vanilla servers. But then they're... I guess.
But they said that they weren't because they were interested in trying in the prospect of it, but that doesn't mean they can do it because according to them,
it's too hard.
It's the upkeep, basically, right?
It's not the upkeep.
Is, or
the
is it the resources?
It's the technology.
Why is it the technology because too high for them?
The technology is actually is the other way around. It's too old. Because it would have to be retro compatible, something like that. Like okay. I remember we talked about this subject the first time we heard about the server being closed, and the reason why they say that they were not doing legacy servers is because the technology is the code that they have is not the same as the code they have today, so they would have to adapt everything so it can be implemented.
Well,
you
that's
know?
Not stopping Nostalrius from doing vanilla servers.
Yeah.
So
yeah, because it's not incorporated on the actual game as of now.
They could do the same thing. Blizzard could totally do the same thing.
I'm pretty sure they could do the same thing.
I'm pretty sure they had the technicians.
It's Blizzard, come on.
They had the guys that could do it.
Like, not to play devil's advocate, but, you know, would you be splitting your player base by doing that?
They're already split. They're already playing on a quote-unquote illegal server.
I would just make, like, an item shop where you have to pay for stuff if I'm going to do a free vanilla server at that point.
Well,
that's
yeah.
just me, though.
Oh, imagine they did the free server and then they had like skins for like future servers, but those are the ones you have to actually pay for.
There you
for.
Go, just make skins.
I don't know. If
people
I could
buy
find,
skins.
If
so.
I could find a good server on Wrath of the Lich King, I would totally jump on that because that was the best expansion for me.
Okay, there you go. So it's a good idea, but I think it's, you know what, I think it's mostly a resource issue. Like if you have so many players and then you have like so many people that have to upkeep the server, and or you have to split your team, your dev team, to actually fix, you know, issues on the server. You're splitting off your existing team to do other projects, right? So I'm pretty sure they have their hands full already with current stuff. So who'd be willing to, you know, okay, you know what? We need three guys to take care of World of Warcraft vanilla servers, you know, or whatever. They can do it.
They could totally do
it. I think they can do it.
I remember that we also mentioned when we were having that discussion a couple months ago, saying that imagine how many players, how many active accounts do they have?
Was it 5 to 10,000?
Yeah, 50.
50?
Yeah. They have like a million registered users. Just registers, but active accounts, they had like 50,000.
Oh, okay.
So like imagine that's 50,000 times $15 that people will be paying if you were going to do that. Doesn't kind of sound like, you know, worth it. I mean, these people are already running a server. Why don't you just hire all of them and have them run your legacy server?
That is very true. Well, who knows what might happen. I know a lot of people who are interested in playing vanilla WoW for free. So...
Nostalros, that's the name.
Yes, Nostalros.
Wait until they're back.
Tell us what you guys think.
It's a good idea.
All right, guys, moving on in the news. So, as we know recently, PewDiePie. It is fun to do.
Yeah,
I can't blame him. He recently trolled the entire internet.
He trolled news media.
He trolled news media.
And very gullible people.
And incredibly gullible people. So he did this video where he was like, that's it. He's like, it was obviously satire. That's it. when I reach 50 million views, I'm...
Subs?
When I, 50 million subs, I'm canceling. I'm going to close my channel. That's all he said. Other comments were made. He says, YouTube is trying to purposely replace me with other trash YouTubers like Lily Singh. Who apparently I think he's friends with, if I'm not mistaken.
Probably.
It was a free promo. You mentioned your name is mentioned on his channel in this free promo. Obviously doesn't think she's a shit YouTuber.
No, no.
But the entire internet got up in arms because some news outlets were like,
biggest YouTuber star is closing down his channel. It's 50 million.
That, and also they were like, PewDiePie shutting down channel, saying YouTube shutting down his channel because he's white.
And that was totally taken out of context.
Taken out of context? They took a 20-second clip from that video where he says they're trying to replace him with trash YouTubers like Lily Singh, and then says, wait, can I say that? I'm white. As a joke. Because she's Indian.
Oh.
Get it?
Oh, Pewds.
So he was like, wait, can I say that? So somehow news media took that out of context and went he thinks they're shutting it out. And then, like, obviously SJWs got all over it. All, like, the more angry ones. And they were like...
Triggered. I'm so triggered right now.
Yeah. Well, you know, like, over something they didn't bother. They just read a headline, didn't bother doing any research and flipped out. And the whole internet freaked out. So he hits 50 million subs.
He's like, okay, guys, I'm really doing it. I'm going to delete my channel. And he deleted his one video channel, which was called Jocksepticeye 2. And he's like, there, I did it. And he said, like, you know when you say a joke and everybody takes it way too seriously? And then there's a montage of all the news outlets being like, oh, my God, PewDiePie closing down his channel. White supremacist PewDiePie, blah, blah, blah.
White supremacist PewDiePie.
But in the end, he managed to pull, like, the biggest publicity stunt ever.
Yeah, pretty much.
He managed to raise one random-ass channel to, like, a million subs a month. And then he got his main channel to 50 million.
50 million is a hell of a...
Jacksepticeye 2 was not a publicity stunt.
No,
made the channel as a joke.
Yeah.
And then posted one video of it.
Yeah.
And you know why? Jack, which is Pew's friend,
one of his friends,
got the golden YouTube thing. He's like, oh, I got 1 million subscribers. Yeah, it was great.
Yeah, it's funny.
Yeah.
So he deleted the channel, trolling the shit out of everybody. He says, I said I was deleting a channel. I never said which one.
Yeah,
in only a way that PewDiePie can say it.
Mm-hmm.
And you troll the entire internet. So 50 million subs. Holy shit.
Wait, that just goes to show you that...
You know what?
Don't believe everything you see on the internet.
No,
I don't know how people didn't see it coming considering the first channel.
Pewds is a troll. I knew it was trolling.
Yeah, we knew. Yeah. We knew it was trolling. Just 1 month ago, he made that channel.
As soon as I saw Jacksepticeye 2, I'm like, I was going to close that channel. Anyways, what do you guys think of Pewds trolling the internet? Are you less gullible now? Did you not believe it?
Or are you still going to believe everything you read in the headlines of every article that you ever see on your Facebook timeline?
Let us know down below. Hey, everyone.
What's up?
Talking about Overwatch?
Great.
Yeah. And how... What? That sounded so sarcastic.
It was.
And how Blizzard helped someone out with their little Overwatch problem.
Okay.
I'm not talking about addiction here. if anything, they fed his addiction. They gave him 500 loot boxes. But there's a story behind that.
Well, Blizzard is very good at making games that are very addicting.
Yes. Long story short, the guy played a ton of summer games.
Okay.
He racked up a ton of coins and bought, like, hundreds of loot boxes and skins, obviously. So he got all the summer game skins.
Nice.
But suddenly, his... in-game currency started...
It disappeared.
It started dropping. Like, actually dropping. And some of his skins were disappearing. Oh, yeah. It's weird.
But to the point where he was in the negatives.
Oh, yeah. He was at negative, like, 30,000 credits.
Well, I learned something today that apparently your coins can go in the negatives.
Yeah.
So you can owe coins, basically.
Yes, you can owe
coins. The Blizzard Visa.
To... It was actually a problem on Microsoft's end, even though Microsoft were like, no, it's not our fault, but it was a chargeback problem. So okay. The money he spent buying currency or boxes, eventually it got charged back. So it's really weird, but he was losing stuff that he had already gained. He went to Microsoft, he went to Blizzard. Blizzard initially went like, well, we can't do anything because it's Microsoft's fault. Microsoft went, we can't do anything because we're Microsoft.
Yeah. It's like constant, like, I didn't do a talk to that person. Well, I didn't do a talk to that person. Yeah,
it was like getting the runaround, in other words.
But eventually, Blizzard were nice enough to say, like, you know what? Your problem is weird. As soon as Microsoft fixes it, we're gonna fix you up on something.
Because it ended up being their fault, technically.
It was Microsoft's fault. Right. It was a chargeback on Microsoft servers. And when it did happen, Blizzard sent him 500 loot boxes.
Whoa.
Yeah, and it took, I believe, over an hour and a half to open them all.
The question is, though, did he get his legendary skins back?
He got all of his skins back.
Oh,
every single one.
So that's like the ultimate hookup.
There were 400 summer game boxes and 100 loot boxes.
Wow. Jesus. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, good guy, Blizzard.
Wow, Blizzard. Again. I've been losing things as well.
Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
That's pretty funny.
Yeah, it's nice. Blizzard are very open with their community.
Well,
about
they
this.
They do a lot of stuff like this. I mean, it's I say a lot, but under weird circumstances,
yeah, they
don't mind going that extra mile.
No, exactly.
Yeah,
and that's one of the things that makes Blizzard so
Blizzard,
great.
Blizzard, yeah. Now let's see EA do that now.
Good luck, or Yubi.
So I think we're done.
Yeah.
We're done.
We're not done yet, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh my God, what's happening?
Who's this guy?
How's it going, guys?
Hi, Santa.
We want to say happy holidays to all of our awesome fans, first of all. Luis is out having a cigarette right now, so he's not going to be a part of this.
You're such a dick.
But we wanted to wish you guys happy holidays, happy new year, Merry Christmas, all that good stuff, Kwanzaa, whatever you celebrate, Hanukkah, you know, all the
holidays.
All the good stuff.
All of the holidays.
Or no celebration.
If you just like to spend time with your cats.
And if you celebrate Orthodox Christmas, watch this video in 2.5 weeks after Christmas.
Point is, we wanted to wish you guys happy holidays, and we're going to have a lot of awesome content for you, though we won't be doing Last Week in Gaming over the holiday break. We will have other awesome content for you, which we're going to be painstakingly mastercrafting for you in our editing studios.
That went in a completely different direction than I thought.
Mastercrafting.
Mastercrafting.
Yes.
Crafting.
Yes. Yeah. All right, guys. So peace out.
Ciao.
See you in 2017.